Myself, Dinesh Kashyap, and here I will be teaching integrated rate equation. The topic for today's class is integrated rate equation. Okay. So very basic background about me is that I have completed my MSc in chemistry and my specialization was physical chemistry from Kurukshetra University. And since 2019, I have been teaching undergraduate students physical chemistry. So, what is an integrated rate equation? An integrated rate equation. Integrated rate equation means, first of all, it is a rate equation, and when we integrate a rate equation, we get an integrated rate equation. And why do we integrate a rate equation? If we have the initial concentration of a reactant and we know the order of a reaction at a particular instant of time, and we want to calculate the concentration of the reactant left at any other particular time, then we can use the integrated rate equation. So integrated rate equation are different for different order of the reaction. So for zero order reaction, our rate law will be something like rate is equal to K concentration of A raised to power zero. The order of the reaction is given by the power to which a reactant concentration term is raised in. Okay, so here the concentration term is raised to the power zero. That's why we can say that this is a zero order reaction. Okay, and the rate law for a zero order reaction can be written something like this: rate is equal to K A raised to power zero. And now here we have written it A raised to power zero, and something raised to power zero is equal to one. So our rate becomes rate is equal to K. Here, K is the rate constant. Okay. And now we know that rate is nothing but decrease in concentration of the reactant with respect to change in time. So we can replace this rate. We can replace this rate by the expression as given here. Minus dA by dt is equal to K. Minus sign, this means that we are writing the rate in terms of the reactant. Okay, so dA means change in concentration of reactant, dt means change in time, and minus dA by dt, this represent nothing but rate in terms of the reactant A. And now we can write it in another form. We can take this dt and multiply it on the other side, on the right hand side, and it will become something like this: dA is equal to minus kdt. Now half of our work is already done. Now we have to integrate this equation, and for the integration we will be requiring the limits of the reaction. Equation 2 can be integrated from initial concentration to any other concentration at time t. तो हमारे पास क्या है? एक तो initial concentration होनी चाहिए और एक हमारे पास क्या होनी चाहिए? Any other concentration at time t. These will be the limits for the concentration. Okay. So as it can be seen here that we have considered that initial concentration of reactant A is nothing but A naught. It is our terminology. Okay, so we have considered that the initial concentration of A is A naught at time t is equal to zero, when we have just mixed our reactant and the time hasn't started. At that instant, the concentration of reactant is A naught. So this will be our initial conditions, that at t is equal to zero, the concentration of A is equal to A naught. And similarly, at any instant of time, means that we have started the reaction and we are monitoring it after 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 1 hour. So that time is called time t, and the concentration of A left at that time is A. Okay, so our limit of integration, initial limits are these, and the final limit are these. Okay, so now we can integrate this equation, and the integration is simply integration from a naught to a dA is equal to minus k integration from 0 to t dt. Here, minus k, we have taken it outside the integration. This is so because all the constant can be taken out of the integration and derivatives, because integration does not work on any constant term. So basically, our expression is something like this. And now we know that the integration of dx is equal to x. We can use this here. On the left side, there is a concentration of A in place of x. On the right side, there is time instead of x. Okay. So the solution will be changed accordingly. Integration of dx is equal to x. This is just what I have written before. So after that, this will become concentration of A. And we can write the limits A naught below and A above. Now we have to put the limits. First, we have to put the upper limit, then we have to put a minus sign, and then we have to put the lower limit. And the expression will be something like this: A minus A naught is equal to minus k t minus 0. Because the solution of right hand side integral was minus k was constant, and there was t, and if we put the limits 0 and t, the expression will be something like the one given below. So our integrated rate equation for a zero order reaction, after we manipulate above expression a little bit, is something like that: k is equal to a naught minus me a divided by t. What we have done here is nothing but multiplied both sides by minus sign. So here there will be a minus sign. This minus sign will be changed into a positive sign, and this minus sign will be changed into a positive sign. And then we have t minus 0. We can neglect this minus 0. And then we have divided both sides by t. So that's for our today. And I hope you liked it. Thank you.